Hi, this is Simon with IQRF. We have designed the IQRF IoT Starter Kit in the way to be connectable to different clouds via bidirectional MQTT channel. So you can collect, store, process and visualize data on a cloud, or you can send your commands to the IQRF network remotely. In this particular video, we will configure the app board to communicate with the Amazon Web Services through the MQTT channel. So let's start. Connect your app board to your local network so it can obtain an IP address using DHCP. In the following steps, you will enter this address into your web browser and configure your gateway through the IQRF Daemon web application. First, create an Amazon Web Services account. You have to fill in your personal or company data and add your credit card details. Your credit card will be used for payments in a case you exceed limits of the selected services. In Services, in the Internet of Things section, find AWS IoT. After selecting this item, click on Get Started in the Onboard section. You will register your device, download the connection kit, and configure and test the connection with your device. Set up how you will be connected to the AWS IoT. Select the Linux operating system and Node.js as the AWS IoT device SDK. Enter the name of your connected device and download the connection kit to get a certificate and keys for a secure MQTT connection. Save and unzip this file. Store the certificate and the keys for further use. Go to the documentation. Here, look up the download root CA string. Search in the entire site. In the search results, find the article using the AWS IoT Embedded C SDK. Here you can find the root certificate. Copy the string and save it as rootca.pam to the directory with other certificates. Next, click Done. In the settings, note the name of your endpoint. You will need it for the upboard configuration. In the IQRF Gateway Daemon web application, click on the Amazon Web Services in the Clouds menu and click on the Add MQTT interface. Enter the name of the endpoint, select rootca.pam as the rootca certificate, iqrfgateway.cert.pam as the certificate, and iqrfgateway.private.key as the private key file. Save the configuration. Inspect the new MQTT interface. iqrf DPA request is the topic for commands, and iqrf DPA response is the topic for responses. Don't change any parameters here. Then, iqrf Daemon must be restarted. After restarting, check the status of the app board if the selected services are running. Now, let's test the connection between the cloud and the gateway. In the web browser, click Test. Enter the IQRF DPA response to the response topic to retrieve the gateway responses. To send commands from the cloud to the gateway, set the IQRF DPA request as the topic for requests. Gateway will expect commands in this topic. Insert a DPA packet in the JSON format into the text box. In our example, we sent a command to turn on the red LED on the coordinator. You can find more commands on the GitHub. We can see that the gateway picked up and executed the command and sent a confirmation with no error into the IQRF DPA response topic. We can visually double check the result of this command. The red LED turned on. So, the bidirectional communication between the IQRF network and the Amazon Web Services is up and running. Now, it's just up to you to use it for your own IoT solution.